If you're a homeowner looking for the best way to ensure clean, healthy drinking water for you and your family, the Cloud RO is the perfect water filter for you. It's the most modern and advanced reverse osmosis system on the market, and today I want to talk about what they've done to address many of the common issues that conventional RO systems have, and why I think this is the perfect system for homeowners with small and large families alike. Starting off with the price point, the Cloud RO costs $750, but at the time of recording, it's currently on sale for $550. It's not the cheapest tank-based conventional RO system I've seen, but it also has a lot more features and benefits than those $200 systems, which I'll talk about here in just a minute. Like all water filter systems, Cloud will only continue to purify your water if you replace the filters, and that means an ongoing cost that you'll also need to account for when budgeting for this system. I estimated the ongoing spend for the Cloud RO to be around 26 cents per gallon, which is based on the combined maintenance cost for all four filters and the battery pack the system uses. So once you've made the initial investment, maintaining the system over the long term is actually extremely cost effective. For some perspective, that's 80 to 90% cheaper on average compared to buying gallons of purified water from the supermarket. So the Cloud RO is a point-of-use reverse osmosis system that gets installed underneath your kitchen sink. It's a conventional model, which means it purifies and stores water in a tank, which is then dispensed from a dedicated faucet. Compared to other conventional RO systems, Cloud has a modern design and a number of unique features. There are four filters: a sediment filter, carbon filter, the RO membrane, and a remineralization filter, which are installed in a housing that sits on the unit base. Everything is nicely compact, and the design is actually pretty attractive considering you're just gonna store it out of the way under your sink. The dedicated faucet is available in four different finishes, and the unit is actually powered by a battery, so it doesn't require an electrical connection. It has a production rate of up to 80 gallons per day, which is honestly more than most folks will need, given that the average person uses just 1 gallon for drinking, plus some additional for cooking. And the storage tank provides instant access to the purified water that's stored, so there's no waiting around or flushing the system before using it. So there are tons of things that I absolutely love about this system, and I'll even say that it is the best reverse osmosis system that I've tested to date. Its efficiency and modern smart features are really what sets it apart from other conventional ROs on the market. It has a 50% recovery rate, which means only 1 gallon of water is wasted for every 1 gallon purified. Unfortunately, water waste is one of the setbacks of the reverse osmosis process in general, but the Cloud RO produces purified water much more efficiently than its competitors. Many other conventional ROs have a worse recovery rate, wasting upwards of 3 to 4 gallons of water for every gallon produced. If we look at the most popular reverse osmosis systems with tanks on Amazon, you'll see the top-selling products are extremely inefficient. So these systems might be cheaper, but they're gonna be wasting 2 to 3 times more water, which really adds up in the long run. In my discussions with people, I found that folks are oftentimes not even aware of reverse osmosis wastewater or recovery rates. And it seems to be because this information isn't readily available online on product marketing pages, which makes sense because it's not really a good selling point for those extremely inefficient systems. And by the way, guys, I'll drop links to all the products I mentioned in this video down in the description. Now, I absolutely love that this system comes with its own dedicated app that shows you tons of cool data from its built-in sensors. It gives you the volume of water in the tank, and the remaining filter and battery life expressed as percentages, and a TDS reading and info about your unfiltered tap water quality, the filtered water, as well as the remineralized drinking water in the tank. You can also track your water consumption over time and set hydration goals, and see how many bottles you saved by not buying bottled water. It gives you a pH reading of the drinking water, so you can see the remineralization filter is working properly to make it more alkaline. There's even info on specific minerals added back to the filtered water with a neat little pie chart indicating percentages. And speaking of that, I really appreciate that the remineralization filter comes built in with this system. One of the biggest complaints about RO water is that it can taste flat or plain, and that's because by removing those minerals and salts, it really takes away those flavor characteristics. So it's really nice that Cloud addressed this, and you don't need an external remineralization filter temperature or to do that manually with trace mineral drops or anything like that. Now, there are a few unique performance features that make the Cloud RO more reliable than a tankless unit. It has a dedicated solenoid valve that shuts off water flow once the optimal volume has been reached in the tank, boosting the faucet flow while also preventing TDS creep, which is an issue common with tankless reverse osmosis systems. And in terms of performance, I'm really happy to see that the manufacturer recently obtained their official certification from the NSF to standard 58 for TDS reduction, which provides solid reassurance of performance. The certification also encompasses material safety, which means you can trust the quality and structural integrity of this product because it's been approved by a reputable organization. At the time of recording, Cloud Water Filters is offering an industry-leading 12-month money-back guarantee, which entitles you to a full refund within this one-year trial period if you don't like the system for whatever reason. And finally, because the unit's powered by a dedicated battery and doesn't require an electrical connection, it can still be used to purify water, even if the power goes out in your home. Now, there really aren't that many things that I would consider unique setbacks for this system. I do wish it was certified for the reduction of some of the other specific contaminants listed on the product page, in addition to the NSF 58 TDS certification. Now, that doesn't mean it will not reduce the others, I'm just saying it would be nice if it was officially certified to do so. However, I do understand that third-party certification is a long and costly process, and small startups like Cloud Water Filters have to pick and choose due to budget constraints. Like other under-sink reverse osmosis systems, this one does require invasive installation, which makes it unsuitable for some specific situations. Plus, as a conventional unit with a tank, it's a bit bulkier and takes up a bit more room than a tankless model. So I tested Cloud RO with municipal water in Denver, Colorado, using Simple Lab's certified lab testing service, TapScore. A number of contaminants with health effects were detected in the unfiltered water, including two disinfection byproducts and fluoride, which were the contaminants that concerned me the most. The DBPs were detected above the health guideline level, so according to the most restrictive guidelines, they were present in concentrations that may have human health effects if consumed over time. Fluoride was detected below the HGL, but we still wanted to reduce it as a precaution because the homeowners have a newborn baby, and research has shown that children under 7 are more prone to some of the adverse effects of fluoride, including fluorosis. Our post-filtration test showed that the Cloud RO had removed 100% of both disinfection byproducts and fluoride, as well as aluminum, copper, chlorine, manganese, molybdenum, and strontium. It also greatly reduced barium by 78% and sulfate by 94%. So the TapScore algorithm assigned a poor aesthetic score to the filtered water due to its high 9.7 alkaline pH. But I really want to call out that this is actually an expected result and something that Cloud promotes the system for. It increased our water's pH from 8.4 to 9.7, which demonstrates its ability to produce mineralized alkaline water and is likely due, at least in part, to a 227% increase in carbonate concentrations post-filtration. However, the TapScore algorithm is actually affected by the high pH because, according to the lab, it may cause a bitter or baking soda-like taste, leave deposits on your fixtures, and have a slippery or soapy feel. The good news is that you don't need to worry about deposits on your fixtures from a point of use reverse osmosis system that has its own dedicated faucet. We also didn't notice any specific taste or texture effects after installing and using the unit. However, some folks may be more sensitive than others. If you're wondering exactly how the remineralization filter affects the purified water quality, the manufacturer claims it reintroduces trace minerals like calcium, magnesium, and potassium, which naturally elevate its pH and make it more alkaline. We actually saw that the calcium in our water was reduced by 93%, magnesium by 55%, sodium by 90%, and potassium was completely removed. While the remineralization stage adds some minerals back into the filtered water, the total mineral content is often still lower than the untreated tap water, showing an overall reduction in mineral concentrations. And I was extremely happy to see that there were no unexpected substances introduced into the filtered water either, which is something we've actually seen from time to time when testing other systems. Now, there might be a few deal breakers for some folks to think twice about before buying this particular system. The first is that the installation process can be a bit lengthy and challenging for those who are not DIY inclined. Like I mentioned, it's an invasive installation that requires drilling into some existing existing fixtures. We actually had to go out and buy a specific diamond-tipped drill bit for the hole in the granite countertop for the dedicated faucet, and we also had to drill a hole in the drain under the sink for the system's wastewater drain line. The reality is that installing the system is going to take more work than a simple plug-and-play system. And if you're currently renting a place, this kind of invasive installation is likely not even an option. So if you'd prefer a system with easier setup, or you are in a rental situation, you should check out this video about the AquaTrue countertop RO. And like I already touched on, just like all reverse osmosis systems, the cloud does waste water, which might be a deal breaker for some folks. Finally, Cloud Water Filters is a newer company and at the time of recording is experiencing some growing pains. So there's currently a wait of up to 4 to 6 weeks before your unit will be shipped after purchase. After installing, testing, and extensively reviewing its features, I really do think the Cloud RO is worth every penny of the upfront cost, especially considering how affordable the replacement filters are. It's going to be a great fit for you if you want to reduce as many contaminants as possible while also remineralizing the purified water. You love the idea of having access to tons of cool data about your water quality, and you're specifically looking for a smarter, modern version of a conventional undersink RO system. But if you're still trying to learn about the different types of reverse osmosis systems currently available, stick around and watch the next video to learn about a few of the tankless RO options which are out there as well. Click or tap to keep watching.